from back.
Amanda! Matimba! Mata! Maibuya, Africa, Maibuya! Maibuya! Maibuya, mnotu Africa, Maibuya!
And Tande, Uguni Bulisa, I greet you all. And I'm so much humbled to be invited into this institute of which I never had an opportunity in my young days to attend to such institutions. So therefore, use it into its maximum in order to liberate ourselves as African in Africa. Comrade, because of time, I'll be very short. There are 3 years that are, or year or decades that I want to reflect into. When Bismarck, somewhere in Berlin, where they called a conference to petition Africa, that year was very important for the continent of Africa. How to come and loot the wealth of Africa. Another year was 1948, when was the fall of apartheid. The last year was the year 1994, when we have compromised our right and our dignity through this facial called democracy of 1994. Amanda! Comrade, capitalism is capitalism. It will never change. It just changes the colors, but it's the same objective at the end of the day. Unfortunately, in 1994, we were compromised, but not only in 1994. In 1993, building up to 1994, from the Southern Development Bank, those secret negotiations that was taking place between the leaders of the National African Congress, those at Nkaunda, that's why you see in the union building, in the private office of the president of the country, you'll find that the daughter of Kenneth Kaunda is sitting there. They can tell you much what happened to those private negotiations that sell our country into the highest bidder. Amanda! Comrade, the 2012 massacre was a well-planned massacre by the capitalist. We've seen our government, our African National Congress, our beloved movement of history, whereby they sold their own people to the highest bidder of the capitalist. We've got a monopoly of the minerals in South Africa, to be specific, platinum. But the price of platinum is still decided by the, or determined by the masters in New York, in Mercantile Stock Exchange. We don't have a say in these minerals. Our brothers are killed because of the very same minerals. The migrant system was created, was enacted to be a law in 1913, when you talk about the Land Act, where our forefathers were forced to leave their subsistence for farming and be brought to come and mine this gold. And this 1994, we thought it will bring relief to the majority of people of South Africa, but we've seen the individual getting richer and richer in the expense of their black brothers, or the majority of the South Africans. Comrade, there is no one who's going to liberate you. You are going to liberate yourself, comrade. If you fold your hands and think someone will come and liberate you, you are wrong. You are dreaming, comrade. Another thing that I need to warn you before I step down: don't love your political party more than South Africa. South Africa must be above everything. The problem of us in South Africa, we love our political parties and then we compromise our continent. It's a high time you put Africa first than your own political party. We need to put the interest of the nation more than the person whom you elected, comrade. Any political parties that we elect to the office is a mere administration block. At the end of the day, after 5 years, you do have the power to change that administration block. There is no amount of violent protest that will bring the capitalists down. You've got an opportunity each and every after 5 years to change the administration. But if you don't utilize that administration, then you turn around and cry foul. Comrade, we are 10 years, we couldn't want a comrade. Comrade, when we talk about industrialization and beneficiation, let me draw some of the history, that something that I've learned. During the Nationalist Party, when South Africa was under sanctions, the National Party's guys were so clever. What they did, they make sure that ESCOM functioned and it employed maximum of many people. They make sure that ISCO is functioning. They make sure that the government itself absorbs many people as much. So therefore, comrade, we do have an opportunity for industrialization and beneficiation with the amount and the monopoly of the minerals that we have. But what I can see, what is coming now, we are getting to the another level of colonization. We are seeing that thing called BRICS. BRICS will never liberate you, comrade. BRICS is another form of colonization, comrade. What they did, remember, it started as a brick. At a later stage, they add S, because South will be the gateway to the West, comrade. That's why they brought you at last, because they could see that they cannot get to Africa without starting in South Africa. Therefore, comrade, as you see the syllabus, now there is this new language that is coming. I don't know it is. Comrade, the job losses is not about the high demand of the mine workers. The job losses is because when they sign these trade deals, it's where we are losing job. We have exported our employment to Asian countries. That's a fact. We cannot do our own things. If other countries come to South Africa to invest, like for instance China, when China come to invest in South Africa, they come with their steel. That's why in Witbank, in Mpumalanga province, Highveld Steel is closing down because of the steel that is getting into our country, and then it's shedding jobs. If they come to build bridges, they come with their own cement, with their own infrastructure, comrade. So there is no investment. That's why it's another level of looting. Amandla! Next time is our 35 hours. Thank you.